Hey everyone, welcome to the first Singularity Computers Ryzen build. Now, it's probably not what you were expecting. No doubt you were expecting a lot more, a custom water cooling loop maybe. But I wanted to cover this build just quickly because it's coming back in a few months for a custom water cooling system, possibly a custom paint job and some mods, you know, some other upgrades such as dual GPUs. So I wanted to show it in its initial form so that when it comes back, we can do the usual, a build log and everything else. Now, from my own experience, particularly in the beginning, I found and still find the most exciting way to build a system when you're building it for yourself is to start completely stock standard. You know, find your baselines with the overclocking, get a whole lot of temperature results and system stats, then move on to one thing at a time. So, you know, the next upgrade might just be custom cables. And the one after that might be, you can see that plug's on a very slight angle. It's because I had to unplug it again just before. I've only just finished this system. You know, the next upgrade might be the water cooling system. And then over time, you continue upgrading it and changing it and improving it so that it's always, in your eyes, perfect. And, you know, then you can stay up to date. It's really what being an enthusiast is all about, and it's the funnest way to build a system. So, you know, I'm really going to enjoy doing this system like this. It might not be much in your eyes now, but when it comes back, yeah, you know, it certainly will be. But we already have, you know, a really good base. The custom cables are all done. So this is full custom cables in this system, not just for the core components. Everything is custom. A lot of time went into that. You know, even though this system doesn't have a custom water cooling loop, I still take a lot of pride in it and really enjoy building something like this. You have to understand, I mean, just ignore everything else that I'm doing here. We always have like 30 things going on at once in the workshop. But these are all of the things that I have to do every day to pay for the channel, to keep all of this alive, you know, to keep everything running. And this is the sort of system that I build that I don't usually put on the channel, you know, that actually helps us pay the bills and feed ourselves. But, you know, you can still see that the usual amount of effort goes into it with the custom cables, the cable management. You know, I still really enjoyed building this system and getting all of this as perfect as I possibly could. So you can see that aside from the custom cables, there is another little mod, which is the addition of the Normandy. The cooler, the AIO, I bet you a lot of people are going to be wondering what that is. It's from Swiftech. RGB lighting, inbuilt pump and reservoir onto the radiator, which is a cool idea. Fill port up here, and interchangeable tube, because you just have some barb fittings, which I really like that. Now take a look at this cool pump. You can actually see the impeller through the pump top, and this is not a normal DDC by the looks of it. That impeller is very different from what I'm used to, so I don't even know really what this is. Something that Swiftech has done. Oh, MCP-300X2. But yeah, this would have to be certainly one of the more interesting all-in-ones with a really nice CPU water block. That actually looks like molded plastic. It's not milled. That is molded, well, not acrylic, some sort of transparent plastic. But yeah, some lighting there too. So we have the Thermaltake Core P5, and I don't have the window on because I'm not going to send it with the window on. Just too much pressure, you know, because it's only attached on those four rods in each corner, which means too much pressure possibly in between during shipping. So I'm better off just wrapping this all up in foam, you know, instead of having that window there, because usually you have an entire case all the way around the perimeter of the window supporting it. So let's get into the components. We have the Ryzen 1800X which is overclocked to 4 gigahertz and 1.4125 volts. I'm very impressed with the temperatures. When it's idling, you know, when I first saw the idle temperature, I was absolutely shocked. It's very hot here. It's about probably 33 degrees. So when you see the idle temperature of 55 degrees, that's a lot higher than I'm used to. I mean, I am used to using custom water cooling loops, but this is still a decent all-in-one. So you would expect lower. But the thing is, when you start pushing it, overclocking it, and when it's at 100% load, the temperature doesn't go up a whole lot. The highest I've seen it at 4 gigahertz, 1.4125 volts, is about 84 degrees. And that's in an ambient of 33. So if you go down to the ambient of 20, which is what I always do to try to get a baseline that's equivalent to what everyone else is doing, you know, it's a fairly decent temperature. I mean, minus 14 degrees, yeah, 70 degrees is what it actually is. Then we have the Asus Crosshair 6 Hero. We have some of the new G.Skill RGB memory, Trident Z. We have an NVIDIA Gigabyte GTX 1080 Ti. A Samsung 960 Pro 512 gig. And around the back we have the Western Digital Red 4 terabyte. Corsair AX860i, and there's also an Asus Wi-Fi card in there. So there's actually two ribbon cables. I have this, well, this is not the one that comes with the case. It's a much nicer one that you can purchase separately. Looks a lot better. And there's one also behind it for the wireless Wi-Fi card. So yeah, as usual, all of the custom cables have been done in MDPC-X sleeve with Singularity Computers wire, pins, connectors. A combination of, well, it's mostly black, and then there's a little bit of white triple X and Italian red for the N7 Normandy theme. But yeah, that's it. This system is fully overclocked. For the GPU, I have, what is it, 150 megahertz over on the core and 175 megahertz over on the memory. No increase in voltage, but the power limit set to the maximum. This overclocks just beautifully. The GTX 1080 Ti is a great overclocker, really enjoying that. Yeah, and I am quite impressed with the overclocking of the 1800X. I have no doubt that when I build a, you know, proper custom water cooling system for this thing, we're going to be able to take it to probably 4.2, maybe 4.4 gigahertz or more. I haven't had a lot of experience with these chips yet, so, you know, I don't want to say numbers that are too high. But yeah, that's it. I also thought, you know, one of the big reasons that I'm doing this video, I should have mentioned this, is for test results. Because, you know, I really want to just have some AMD performance results on the channel. And this was our chance, because I haven't had the opportunity to do a review or, you know, anything like that. So yeah, we're now going to take a look at the performance and temperature results for this system. And then we can compare them when it returns. This PCB here, by the way, comes with the all-in-one. It's for the RGB lighting, fans, pump RPM, the whole lot. Okay, that sums up this video. Thanks for watching, and remember that none of this would be possible without our patrons.